Every day, we use water in a variety of different ways. Whether it is to drink, cook, or shower, water is an integral part of our lives, and it is something many of us take for granted. Water is there when you turn on the tap, but do you know where your water comes from? The history behind the Grand Rapids water system and its sources of drinking water through the years start in 1875 along the banks of the Grand River. The original Coldbrook pumping station was built near the intersection of Monroe and Coldbrook. The city's water treatment system consisted of a gravel and sand bed filter in the middle of the Grand River near Coldbrook Pumping Station. Over the years, the quality of water coming from the Grand River made it much harder to treat effectively. In 1912, the city constructed the Monroe Filtration Plant, located at 1430 Monroe Northwest. The Monroe Filtration Plant would continue to treat Grand River water as the primary source of drinking water for the city until 1940. It was then that the city constructed the first of two transmission mains from Lake Michigan. While Grand River water would still be used periodically as a source during times of higher demand through the 1980s, the city effectively relied on Lake Michigan as its source water since 1940. In 1962, the Lake Michigan Filtration Plant was built in Grand Haven Township. When the city began to move its treatment operations to this new location, it gave the city a capacity of 60 million gallons per day. In 1992, the city officially moved all of its treatment operations to the Lake Michigan Filtration Plant after it was expanded to the treatment capacity of 135 million gallons per day. Before the water reaches your tap, a lot happens to make that water safe for our customers. Your water starts its journey to the treatment plant by entering through one of two intakes, located approximately 1 mile out into Lake Michigan and 45 feet below the surface of the water. Surrounding the intakes are crib structures to help protect and secure the integrity of the intakes. Before the water is ready for treatment, it is first screened to remove any large debris. After passing through the initial screens, the water is pumped from the 1940 and 1991 low-lift pumping stations to the treatment plant. Once the water enters the plant, it is ready for treatment. A variety of chemicals are added to the water to keep it safe for human consumption. Sodium hypochlorite, otherwise known as bleach, is added to begin the disinfection process and eliminate harmful bacteria. Aluminum sulfate, or alum, is added as a coagulant to bind with the solids in the water to form larger particles that will settle out of the water. A small amount of fluoride is added for community health. The Grand Rapids water system in 1945 was the first in the country to add fluoride to its water supply. Phosphate is added for corrosion control purposes to protect our pipes in the water system. Seasonally, during the warmer months, carbon is added for taste and odor control associated with lake water algae. After chemical addition, water starts its treatment by traveling through the flocculation and settling basins. Through a series of fast mixing and slow mixing, larger particles are formed, called flocculate, which aid in the settling process. These particles become heavy and settle out of the water column. The water leaving the settling basins then travels to the filters to begin the final stage of particle removal and purification. The water flows vertically through rapid sand filters consisting of layers of anthracite coal and sand. The average flow through the filters is about 3,000 gallons per minute. The clean, filtered water then goes into two 5 million gallon storage tanks located outside of the filtration plant. The average daily demand is 35 million gallons, with higher demand in the summertime. From the storage tanks, it is pumped into town through two transmission mains. One, following Lake Michigan Drive, is a 46-inch transmission line that was installed in 1940. The other is a 60-inch transmission line following Fillmore Street, which was installed in 1991. The water starts its journey to our customers with the assistance of our high-lift pumps for each of the transmission mains. There is a high-lift pumping station containing multiple pumps to pump the water into town through each transmission line. Treated drinking water from Grand Rapids is distributed to many communities throughout Ottawa and Kent counties and covers nearly 137 square miles and roughly 300,000 residents. At any given moment, up to 70 million gallons of water is stored in the distribution system to provide enough water for all customers. Multiple storage tanks and system pumps throughout the distribution system deliver water to our customers' taps. The treatment process and pumping of your water is a 24/7, 365-day-a-year operation and is continuously monitored for safety and water quality by state-licensed operators and chemists. In town, the water distribution technicians monitor and repair the distribution system to ensure the delivery of safe drinking water. Each step of the water treatment process to the water coming out of your faucet is monitored by licensed professionals. We at the Grand Rapids Water System spend each day protecting the public health of our customers and making sure each step of the process is safe. If you have questions or concerns about your drinking water or would like a tour of the Lake Michigan Filtration Plant, please contact customer service at 311 or 616-456-3000.